20. I'm a junior and I'm a guard.
Alexa Holland, junior guard, number 10.
Ali Larkin, junior guard, number 30.
Bailey Abbott, senior forward, number 24.
Hi, I'm Keaton Stasiak. I'm a junior and I'm a forward, number 12.
Grace Pfeiffer, freshman guard, number 14.
Alexis Elliott, freshman guard, number 22.
Kennedy Moslem, freshman center, 44.
Morgan Ruff, freshman guard, number 32.
I'm Alexa Garrison, number 40, and a sophomore forward.
Emma Dahlquist, freshman center, number 54.
Jimtown High School, the second game of the semifinal round of the Jimtown sectional. Game one went to St. Joe over Marion by 21, 62 to 41. So they will cruise on into the championship tomorrow night, tentatively, weather permitting. So Rochester in their home whites, they'll go to our right. And Culver Academy Lady Eagles in their maroons road gear, they're going to our left. It'll be Stiers and Falco to jump center. And the Academy Lady Eagles win the attempt. Holzer runs the point. Here comes the run and jump defense. Steyer outside, and Rochester already forces the first turnover of the game, 7 seconds in.
Culver had 37 turnovers in that first game.
There's one.
Yeah, Lady Zebras, again, forcing a turnover. They had a lot of success with that here at the end of the season.
Looks like a 2-1-2 zone right now by the Culver Academy Lady Eagles. Down low to Stasiak for jumper, and the cane is good. King Stasiak got a deflection, and now we're going to have another travel. Holland forces another travel, another turnover, and Rochester is going to get it back underneath their own basket baseline left. 30 seconds gone in the first quarter. Axel looks to trigger it in. Holland studies. Over the top, the defense to Malco. Becky, left side of the floor, drives to the left side and has her pass kicked out of bounds by Stiers. I'll stay with Rochester right in front of Coach Chris Lee. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Early on in this second game here at Jimtown, Rochester up 2-0. Right side to Stasiak. Going to make that, yeah, Stasiak.
Yeah,
the Larkin, Stasiak in the right wing.
Kind of unusual to see her outside of the paint.
Maybe that's what threw me a little bit. Baseline to Larkin, drives the baseline, pull up 15-footer, is off the mark, no good. Offensive rebound to Holland. X behind the arc, gives to Malco. She drives in the paint. Her pass is then kicked away by the Academy and out of bounds. It'll stay with Rochester.
Rochester doing a good job working against that zone. They've been able to get inside to the paint a couple of times already in the first couple of possessions.
I'd like to see Becky rise up and shoot that. Becky gets the pick at the elbow. Out to Holland. Makes a three behind the left wing. Goes to the top of defense to Malco. Skip pass to Stasiak. She's blocked the paint. Ball loose. Off the foot of Holzer. And the Academy will stay with Rochester. Minute 10 gone in this game. Rochester up 2-0. Holland looks to get it in. Goes the top of the defense to Larkin. Allie, a left wing. Now in the middle of the floor, works to the right side to Malco. Behind the arc, right side. Down low to Stasiak. Keaton backs away and kicks it out to Holland. Heck, 10-footer right side is good. And Rochester up 4-0.
Good ball movement by Rochester and a good job of keeping the ball alive on the missed shots. Long possession for them on the offense end.
For the first time tonight, Culver has it across the timeline. Stiers for three, top of the key is good. Leave her alone as Victoria Stiers is going to drill that every time and cut this four-point lead to one.
She had a couple of threes against Rochester in that earlier game.
Yep. Rochester with it going to our right. Holland against Stiers, top of the key. 2-3 zone by the Academy. Three for Larkin is no good. Defensive rebound by Stiers. Stiers hesitates, now accelerates down the right side of the floor. Oh boy, misses Holzer wide open down low.
Ooh,
and on the far side, yeah, Larkin's going to pick up a reach-in foul.
So a couple of scores from around the area. South Central defeated Triton 40-34. They'll more than likely face Oregon Davis tomorrow in that sectional.
Highly likely.
Tippecanoe Valley over Northwood 63-58 in double overtime. So they'll move on to the championship.
Lady Vikings going on to the championship game tomorrow night. They will get either Wawa C or Whitco. Frank goes to the basket, foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Bailey Abbott going to pick up that reach-in foul. And that's going to send the junior, Peyton Frank, to the line to shoot two for Lady Eagles. 5:47 to play, first quarter. Rochester up 4-0.
That foul's on Malco. That's her first. I didn't even know she was in. Playing well in the paint.
I agree. And that's what she's doing. She's walking over the bench with her palms in the sky. Not even close. Frank's free throw hits nothing but air. and she'll have one more. Now looking to tie this one up at four with 5:47 to play in the first quarter, and now they're going to discuss it. They're going to discuss, and they're both officials discussing it, looking at Bailey Abbott. They're going to change this foul. It should have been 24, not 20. 5:47 to play in the first quarter, 4-3, Rochester leading, and Frank at the line for one more free throw for the Lady Eagles. The official walks over to the scorer's table, and I got a feeling they're going to change this foul. Yeah, Bailey Abbott now will be saddled with that foul. So Frank at the free throw line for one more. Frank, Isaac, flies it, second one good, and we're tied at four. So Rochester starts with a 4-0-1, and now the Academy has answered that 4-0 run with their own. Here comes the half-court trap. Holland crosses the timeline, high on the right side to Larkin, left side to Malco. Becky feeds down low to Bailey Abbott, to a cutting Holland. Extra lane is going to be fouled. It's going to be on the shot or before. It's going to be before the shot. So it'll be out of bounds for Rochester, and that foul is going to be whistled against Frank or the Academy. Bounce pass into Larkin. Allie on the left wing gives to Holland. Makes the three, drives the baseline. Pull up 15-footer left side is off the back of the rim. No good. Rebound, ball four. And we're going to have a tie-up down low between Stasiak and also Etheridge. And it will go back to Rochester on an offensive rebound.
Nice job by Stasiak. She got blocked out. But when Etheridge come down with the basketball, she turned that direction. Stasiak grabbed the hold of it.
Larkin, top to Malco. Between the rings, left side to Holland. X looks at the three, now drives inside the three-point line, loses the handle, now picks up the dribble.
Wow.
Loses the handle again, and she's going to be fouled finally by
Sires. Boy, she was really giving her a rough time trying to handle that basketball over there on the baseline.
5:15 to play in the first quarter, tied at four. Rochester basketball going to our right. Becky Malco runs the point. Academy in a 2-3 zone. Corner, down low to Stasiak. She's being buried, and she is fouled down low by the Academy. Is that going to be on Etheridge? Is that going to be on Frank? We'll wait and see. It's either Frank or Holzer.
It is Frank. That's her second.
So probably Kerry Christie is going to go to the bench. He is. And he'll bring in McKinnis. Margaret McKinnis, a 5'6 junior, and checks into the game for the Academy. 5:05 to play first quarter, tied at four. Holland, bounce pass in the lane to Malco, rises up in the paint, and it gets to go. Becky Malco has her first two of the game. Rochester back up 6-4. Rochester has it deflected. They get called, has it deflected by Rochester, the Heiser, and over the top of the head to the cutting McKinnis, out of bounds. And they go back to Rochester on another Academy turnover. 6-4. Rochester on top. 4:45 to play in the first quarter.
Academy will pick them up mid-court.
Yep. Holland, high on the right side, between the rings to Larkin, back to Holland. Three, right side for the Lady Zebras, off the mark, way off the mark. Rebound to Sires. Sires with the basketball, around Holland, middle of the floor, left side of the lane, goes to the basket hard, throws up a shot off the glass, and it's good.
Yeah, Rochester has to do a better job stepping in front of her when she's bringing the ball down the floor.
Morgan Ruff will check in at the next opportunity, and Stasiak fouled again. This time it will be Holzer. And if Culver keeps this up, Rochester is going to be shooting in this quarter.
Well,
because it's a deja vu.
Yeah, they shot 28 free throws in that earlier game in November, and 14 of them were in the first two quarters.
So Morgan Ruff is in for the first time for Rochester. Holland comes out. Larkin on the right wing, top of the key to Malco. One dribble left side to Ruff. Bow to Malco. Becky, stop. Down to Stasiak. She's fouled again. Stasiak going to be fouled again, this time by Etheridge. That'll be out of bounds to Rochester, and Rochester, on the next team foul by the Academy, will shoot free throws from here on out.
Yeah. Geez.
And now Coach Chris Lieb and the Lady Eagles will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
The girls of summer here.
Jenstown High School. After the Academy timeout, it'll be Rochester basketball underneath their own basket. Baseline right. Larkin looks triggered in. Allie slaps the basketball. Things move around. Allie looking to get it in, does so in the corner to Malco. Becky to the wing, top to Ruff, and she travels going to the basket.
That's the first turnover for Rochester.
So after the turnover for Rochester, the Academy will get it back. We're tied at six here in Jimtown. And now we're going to have a blocking foul on Bailey Abbott. That'll be number two, and X will come back into the game. And McGinnis, who just came in the game, was fouled driving the baseline. So Holzer will look to get it in, baseline right. So Holland back in, and Bailey Abbott, two personal fouls, will sit down. Holzer will look to trigger it in. Gets it in to Steiner. Steiner dribbles top of the key against Larkin, left side to Holzer, in the left corner against Stasiak. Holzer picks up her dribble, gives to a cutting Steiner. Her shot blocked out of bounds by Ruff. No,
she
must have lost it on the way up, and it hits the back of the backboard and goes out of bounds. I thought Morgan Ruff deflected that, but they're going to give it to Rochester. I'll make that Malcolm through the center circle. We're tied at six, 3:45 to play the first quarter. Becky drives, rises up in the paint, partially blocked, picked up the rebound of the Academy, gives to Etheridge. Etheridge left side of the floor, she picks up her dribble outside to Holzer. Holzer around the defense to Stiers. Stiers against the 2-3 zone. Rochester is in a 2-3 zone. Now to Steiner. Steiner dribbles to the top of the key against the double team over the top of the defense to Holzer. Left wing pass to Stiers. Pushes it to Etheridge. She drives and she's going to be fouled by Morgan Ruff.
Ruff was a little late getting around on the zone when it was rotating around to the other side of the floor.
3:16 to play first quarter. Kennedy Musselman checks in for the first time tonight. 6-foot freshman replaces King Stasiak with 3:16 to play in the first quarter. Boy, if these girls are too quick for Morgan and Bailey, this shouldn't take long.
Let's hope we can get a half-court offense.
Hey, good for her. Kennedy, the ball loose on the floor. Kennedy jumps on it, and she and McGinnis was tied up.
Yep.
It'll stay with the Academy baseline right.
You always seem so surprised.
Holder gets into the tires. He has it knocked out of bounds by Malco.
Well,
this isn't my first rodeo with her.
Okay.
You know, I've seen this picture before. Holzer looks to trigger it in again, baseline right. Triangle and two right now by the Lady Zebras. Holzer gets it into McGinnis. Back to Holzer. Three over Musselman from the baseline. In and out. No good. Rough at the board. Rips and runs to Bo. Bo, middle of the floor. Bo, right side, travels.
She had the right idea. She just couldn't stop the momentum.
Dean Stasiak will come back into the game. Stasiak will replace Morgan Ruff from Lady Zebras. 2:57 to play in the first quarter, tied at six. Culver will have the basketball going to our left, Culver Academy. And Stiers will bring it up the floor. She'll be picked up by the half-court trap over the top to Holzer. Holzer to a cutting Etheridge. Etheridge in the paint, fouled by Musselman. And that's going to send her to the line to shoot two. What happens when we – it's going to be out of bounds, not on the shot. And regardless, what happens when we reach? Holzer will look to trigger it in. Baseline left. Still looking to get it in. And then Musselman blocks the shot of McGinnis and gets the rebound against the Holland. Holland right side, now in the paint. Outside to Larkin. Larkin out to Holland on the left wing. To Malco. Feeds down low to Stasiak. Backs her way in, throws up a shot. It's no good. And the rebound to the Academy. And quickly to Steiner. Steiner, her layup is no good. Holland with the rebound. Holland runs right side of the floor. Holland, high on the right side, hesitates, looks down low to Musselman, gives top to Malco, back to Holland. Holland lobs it down low to Musselman, gets it, she puts it up, she's fouled the shot, still going to line to shoot two.
Nice job, she established her position down on the block, had a defense on her high hip, and Holland made a good pass to the low side.
Holzer picks up a foul for a second. And Kennedy Musselman will be at the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras. We're tied at six. First one for the freshman is good, and we're not tied anymore.
And that was a 16 foul on Culver. So
we were at six for a long time.
Yeah, we were.
2:15 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 7-6. Holzer comes out of the game. I didn't get the number. I think number three, maybe. Cortez comes in for Holzer. Second for Musselman, no good. Stasiak with the rebound. Put back on the way. Going to foul.
Nice job by Stasiak again in the right place at the right time.
Morgan Ruff will come back in. And She'll replace Allie Larkin for Rochester, who now leads by three. And Keaton Stasiak, the 5'3 junior at the line, to try to complete the three-point play.
Cortez was with the foul. That's her first.
Stasiak has one free throw. Ties it, flies it, buys it. 10-6, Rochester, 2:12 to play in the first quarter.
Four-point swing for Rochester on that possession.
Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman, or Jimtown High School. Winner of this game will get St. Joe tomorrow night in the championship. McGinnis in the paint. McGinnis has it stripped away. Malco has it. Right side of the floor. Malco runs. Here comes the Sires of the trailer. Layup is no good. Rebound tipped around. Malco has it. Outside to Holland for three. Left wing. In and out. No good. Stasiak's putback is good.
Stasiak with 7 points.
Working hard.
Quarter. Yes, she is.
Timeout Academy. It will be a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Once again, the winner of this contest will return tomorrow night right here in Jimtown to face the South Bend St. Joe Lady Indians at 7 o'clock sharp. 7 o'clock tomorrow night, the championship game of our Class 3A sectional.
In the first quarter, Rochester up 12-6. They're on a 6-0 run. Sires down low, have the pass tipped away and stolen by Stasiak. Keaton is all over the place in the first quarter.
That's the seventh turnover now for the Academy.
Musselman down low, good and a foul. Great wraparound pass by Malco to Musselman. She hits the hoop and the harm, and she'll go to the line for one.
Foul coming against Steiner, her first teammate.
And back into the game is Holzer.
Rochester taking advantage of their speed and quickness. Get a good step or step and a half against Culver.
You do see 44 in the floor, right?
I stand by my comments.
Kennedy's free throw is good as she completes a three-point play. So Allie Larkin comes into the game, and Kennedy will come out. Rochester now up 15-6 with a minute 20 to play in the first quarter.
4 points for Musselman in that 2.5 minutes.
I'll take it. Rochester in a run and jump defense. Steiner, high on the left side, gives to McGinnis. McGinnis against a double team, flips down low, ball's loose. Stasiak again with a
steal.
Yep. A minute to play. Stasiak right side of the floor, left side of Holland to the baseline. X behind her back dribble, goes to the baseline, kicks it out to Larkin, high on the left side, swings right side to Rupp, down the corner to Malco. Pecky against the zone defense. Gives the hollow left wing. X rises the free throw line, kicks it out to Ruff. Thought about shooting, out of Malco. Drives the baseline, and she's going to be called for travel. 42 seconds play in the first quarter, Rochester by 9. Here at Jimtown High School, again, the championship game tomorrow night, weather permitting. And I say that in all seriousness because I was told that exact same thing by the officials here at Jimtown. The jumper by Academy Blackbird is no good. And it's not out of bounds by Rochester. It'll stay with the Academy baseline right.
Well, you got to remember, we are in Elkhart County.
Yep.
And that they are under a storm warning already from now until tomorrow night.
Cortez in the paint against Ruff. She travels. Nice defense by Morgan Ruff, not allowing Cortez to get a good look at the bucket and force a travel. So Rochester up 15-6. Time winding down here in the first quarter, and probably we've seen this year after year. They'll probably look for the final shot of the period.
Oh, absolutely.
Malco stands in the center circle and dribbles.
Just a matter of the execution, whether or not we can hang on to it for another 15 seconds.
Malco dribbles in the center circle with 10. Becky dribbles with 8. drifts to her right with 7. Down the wing with 5. Top of the key to Holland with 3. Next works the left side with 2. Next step back 3. The buzzer is off the window. No good. After the first quarter, Rochester leads 15-6. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Here we go to the second quarter. Rochester leading 15-6. And, Brad, that first quarter was all Keaton State's rebounds, yeah. Steals, points. It was all Keaton.
You're right. And she, you know, took advantage of some opportunities where her teammates got her the ball down low. She took advantage of some opportunities that she created by stepping into the passing lane and taking the ball away from Culver when they weren't making very good decisions.
The Rochester starts the second quarter of the basketball going to our right. Morgan Ruff back into the game. She gets it into Holland. X on the right wing. Picks up a dribble. Now to Larkin. Allie back to Holland right side. Backs away from the double team. And has her pass stolen by Steyer. Steyer will go in for the left-handed layup. It is no good. And the rebound to Larkin. Allie Larkin hesitates. Now gets to Holland. X against the double team. Now slows up. Pushes across the timeline to Malco. Becky around the double team. Works to the wing. Has it stolen again. Steyer's left side of the floor against Holland. Steyer down low to Steiner. She travels. Holland forces another turnover.
Well, CGA's had some opportunities in that first quarter and here early in the second quarter, and they haven't been able to capitalize by putting the ball in the hole.
Now they're in a full court press, and Malco's lazy pass is going. Steiner layup. No! Stasiak another rebound, and she is fouled, and she'll go to the lane to shoot one of the bonus.
Well, that's half a dozen layups we've seen Culver miss, or at least shots within 3 to 4 feet.
Yeah, and that was closer than that.
Yeah.
7:16 to play in the first half. Rochester by 9. Stasiak will go back on the line to shoot one of the bonus, looking to push it to double digits.
But Cortez picks up her second foul.
Keaton Stasiak at the line for one of the bonus. The 5'3 junior slides in. Let the first one go. No good. And the rebound to Steyer. Steyer pushes for the academy. Left side of the floor. She'll go in for the left hand. Lamp is blocked in a foul way. Malco, get out of here.
Great defense by Becky Malco.
And back in is Etheridge for the academy.
She's holding her shoulder like maybe she might have pulled that out, pulled a muscle or something.
I would think
that
so.
Out of bounds.
The long 2-point shot by Blackburn goes, and it's 15-8. Full court press by the academy.
Well, first bucket by the academy in almost 8 minutes, 5 minutes.
Holland travels, gives it back to the academy.
That's our third turnover in a row now for Rochester.
Yeah, it was a long time. I think it was around 4 minutes of playing the first quarter, and we're tied at 6.
5-6 minutes anyway without a bucket.
Blackburn again, left side. Nope. Morgan Ruff with the rebound. Ruff dribbles away from traffic. She loses the handle, picks up the basketball. We're going to have a 30-second Rochester timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Rochester takes a 30-second timeout.
Rochester's leads down to 7. The academy in a full court press, and Brad, that seems is working right now for the Lady Eagles.
Yeah, they forced Rochester into at least 3 turnovers here.
And now Etheridge has picked up a foul 27 feet away from the basket, and Becky Malco will go to the line to shoot 2 free throws.
Well, that'll be Etheridge's second. So the foul's starting to add up for Culver's. Frank and Etheridge and Holzer and Cortez all with 2.
Malco fires the first one. It's good. She'll have one more. Looking to push this lead back to 9 with 6:42 to play in the first half. Malco's second on the way. Becky drains the second one to push the lead to 17-8. Holzer quickly up the floor for the academy. Holzer, middle of the floor, pass down low, taken away by Ruff. Low against the double team, now gives to Holland. Holland, middle of the floor, now at the Culver Academy timeline, gets it across the timeline, gives to Larkin, who drives it right. Larkin inside the three-point line, gets away with the travel, now to Stasiak, gives it out to Holland, and makes it to Malco, and it's stolen away by Steyer. And she has a flex out of bounds again by Malco. Get out of here!
Well, Rochester's going to have to figure out a way on offense to work. Culver's bringing three girls out on the ball, and one of them, a fourth one, floating in the passing lanes, and that's what's creating the turnovers.
Etheridge at the free throw line, out to Steiner. Steiner, 18-footer over Larkin, is no good, and it goes out of bounds. Go back to Rochester.
Well, great job on Malco, though, coming in, trailing the play, and making the block without making contact on the play.
Here's what I'm impressed with.
Uh-huh.
Whether it's a turnover, whether it's a make, whether it's a missed shot, Culver's pressing, and there is another turnover. And now we're going to have a tie. Nope. Culver's going to get it back. Dyer goes to the basket. Layup. Good. 17-10. And they're full court press again.
That's,
I think, that one, unfortunately, is still here.
Yeah.
And boy, Dyer's just bailed out. Larkin is, that was almost another turnover. And X will go to the line to shoot two with 5:55 to play in the first half, up by seven.
Now Stiers with her second foul. So the entire first six for Culver has two fouls.
We've got some scores to pass along to you. One upset, I think, at North Newton High School as Holland misses the first free throw. She'll have one more as Justin beat the sectional favorite, Delphi, by the final of 45-26. Second of a Holland's good this time. 18-10, Rochester. 5:45 to play first half. Steiner across the timeline to Steiner. Steiner drives the baseline. Dumps down low to Steiner. Full away jumper. The paint is good. Now the Rochester lead down to six. Larkin looks to get it in. Does so to Malco. I'm sorry, to Holland. Heck pushes up the floor. Cross court to Malco. Becky runs down the floor, right side of the floor. Stop. Kicks it outside to Holland, a little reset on the right wing. Now left side of Larkin, back to Holland for three, right side, in and out, no good. Bad scramble for the rebound. There's going to say last touch by the Academy, out of bounds. Rochester will keep possession, baseline left. 5:15 to play in the first half.
Rochester does not have a field goal here in the second quarter. They've got 3 out of 5 from the free throw line.
Larkin to Holland. Back to Larkin on the left wing. Larkin around the defense, dribbles to the free throw line, out to Larkin, down to Stasiak. Keaton put up the shot, no good. Rebound, ball court, she gets it and bangs it off the leg of the Academy, out of bounds. Keaton bangs it off the leg of the Academy, goes out of bounds, and then she had to sidestep the ball, but she just banged off the leg.
Get out of the way so it didn't ricochet back off of her.
Kennedy Musselman back into the game. Allie Larkin sits down, 5:05 to play first half. Holland looks to get it in. Still looking to get it in. Over the top of the defense to Ruff. Ruff middle of the floor, right side to Holland. Holland works it right. Got it. Ruff to Larkin to Holland in the paint. Pull-up jumper from 10 feet. Good off the window. Rochester back up by 8.
That's the first field goal for Rochester in the second quarter.
Yeah, that was a tough one, too.
Yeah, it was.
Blackburn, pull-up jumper over the defense is no good. Stasiak into the rebound, and she's going to be fouled by Blackburn, and Keaton will go back in the lane to shoot two.
The Blackburn picks up her first.
What? First?
Yeah, I know. It's hard to believe. Somebody in the game that hasn't fouled yet. But that's their 12th team foul in this first half.
So Stasiak in the line.
For the third time in the ball game.
Looking to push this lead to double digits. Keaton has two. Burson for the junior. Good. So I have one more. Back into the game is Frank, and Blackburn sitting down for the Academy. Brad Thomas on David Musselman. 4:43 to play in the first half. Rochester by 9. And Keaton Stasiak will have one more freebie for the Lady Zebras, looking to push this for the first time tonight in double digits. The junior does so. 22-12. The Academy runs. Holder over the top of the defense. The Steiners. Steiner. Outside to Etheridge. Etheridge in the block. Kicks it outside to Steyer. Steyer's in the paint. Jumper over the defense. No good. Musselman rips the board and gives the Ruff. Ruff around the defense and runs for Rochester. Pushes ahead to Malco. Malco on the high on the right side. Down low to Musselman. Has her pass taken away by Etheridge. Now gives to Holzer. Holzer left side of the floor for the Academy Eagles. Jump stop. Outside to Etheridge. Now to Holzer for three. Short. Rebound to Malco. Gives it wrap around to Holland. She stays in going out of bounds to Stasiak. Keaton on the baseline. She's going to be fouled by Holzer, and that's going to send Stasiak to the line to shoot two.
Holzer will pick up her third.
And I'm not sure about that one.
That was kind of an incidental trip.
Yep.
Rochester never really had possession of that basketball at any one point.
I agree. That was helter-skelter for sure. Cortez will come back in the game for the Academy after Stasiak's first free throw. Is there an MVP in the semifinal round?
Oh, if you want to.
Give it to 12.
Yeah.
Already.
I would agree.
Free throw is good by Stasiak. Rochester by 11. How many does she have out of the 23?
That's 10 now for Stasiak. 4 or 5 from the line.
Dean with one more, looking to push this lead to 14 with 4 minutes to play in the first half. Keaton eyes a second one, lets it fly. It's good again. 24-12. Rochester up. 4 minutes to play in the first half. Steiner, high on the right side. Rochester in a 2-3 zone over the top of the defense to Steiner. Steiner holds above her head. One dribble, works to the middle of the floor to Cortez. Down the baseline to Steiner. A step back, looks at a three. Ball's loose. Ball still loose. Steiner on the high left side picks it up for the Academy. Rochester falls back into that 2-3 zone. Etheridge in the corner to Cortez. Cortez, one dribble, cross-court pass to Steiner. She travels, no call. Outside to Etheridge, she'll fire a three over Holland. It is good. Nope, that's a two. I beg your pardon. That's a two. 24-14. Rochester up by 10 with 3:20 to play in the first half. Nopko around the defense, works high to the right side. Jump stop, top of the key to Ruff, west side to Holland. Heck, wide open three, left wing. Nope, too hard. And the rebound to Steyer. Steyer's for the Academy, right side of the floor. Jump stop, feeds down low to Cortez. She'll take the 10-footer to the baseline. No good. Musselman rips the board and gives to Stasiak. Keaton ahead to Malco. Becky on the right side of the floor. Now we'll slow up and we'll reset a little bit for Rochester at the volleyball line and between the rings. Right side to Ruff. Ruff on the baseline to Malco. Becky, top of the key to Holland. Next, backs away behind the three-point line and then loses the basketball. And they're going to say last touch by Holland and going to go to Rochester. How does that happen? The ball goes behind you.
Yeah, she goes towards the basket. The ball goes back towards the scorer's table, and they're going to say it hit her last. So I don't get it.
Uh-huh. New one on me. 2:40 to play in the first half.
Rochester's 11th turnover.
Ball's tipped away. Keaton Stasiak steals it. 1-on-3 break. Malco loses the handle. Out of bounds. It'll go back to the Academy on another Rochester turnover.
Both teams now at 12.
Yep. The Academy started out turning it over about every time for a while.
You're right.
Steiner for three. Good left wing shot. And that cuts the lead to 7 at 24-17. Full court press for the Academy Eagles. Holland across the timeline left for Rochester. 2:13 to play in the first half. Rochester up 24-17.
Well, that full court press has been successful for the Academy.
Stasiak kicks it out to Holland, top of the key to Ruff. Low at the free throw line, pull-up jumper on the way, is off the mark, no good. And the rebound to Sires for the Academy. Sires blows up, now pushes down the right side of the floor. Bounce pass to Etheridge, she has the basketball. She travels again, no call to Steiner. High on the left side for the Academy, a minute 45 to play in the first half. To Frank, over Musselman, no good. Rebound to Holland, Rochester runs. 95 seconds to play, first half, Rochester by 7. Holland high on the left side to Ruff. Moe, baseline to Malco. 15-foot on the way is in and out, no good. And the rebound to Culver, and we're going to have a reach-around foul by Stasiak. And that'll be the team 6th on the Lady Zebras with 1:26 to play. And the first half.
Stasiak first.
How many team fouls on Culver?
13.
Larkin comes back in, Ruff comes out. 1:25 to play first half. Rochester by 7. It's been as big as 14 in this quarter. Sires, we're going to have an illegal screen on the Academy. Cortez is going to pick up another foul.
That's her third. Team 14th.
Coach Chris Lee not happy with that call. 1:18 to play in the third. Rochester by 7. Larkin gets it into Stasiak. Keaton pushes outside to Holland. And now Alexa holds up a little bit and gives to Malco. Back to X on the right wing. Back to Malco. Bounce pass to Larkin. She'll fire a three left baseline. Is off the back of the iron. No good. Stasiak into the board. Kicks it out to Holland. X on the wing. Clock runs under 55 seconds to play in the first half. Rochester by 7. It looks like Rochester will look for the final period, shot of the period as the Academy looking to be, Brad, in a 2-1-2 zone. Holland almost has the pass picked off. Has it now on the right wing.
They've got the floor spread to the four corners. They've got to be a little smarter with their passes, trying to get it across court to each other.
38 seconds. Holland in the center circle. Now drifts to her right with 33. Back to Malco, high on the left side with 30. Dribbles away from the defense. Jumps top at the three-point line. Out to Holland with 27. Next, near the timeline. Drives towards the bucket. Now bounces back. Now outside to Larkin with 20. Alley, wraparound pass to Holland with 19. Now to Larkin, middle of the floor with 18, or with 15. Outside to Holland with 12. Now to Malcolm in the center circle with 10.
Culver just keeps pushing him back closer and closer to the mid-court stripe.
Malcolm then travels. Rochester ran off 50 seconds in that quarter, and now the Academy will have one final shot out of here with 6 seconds to play in the first half. 24-17 Rochester. The Academy of the basketball going to our left with 6 seconds to play in the second quarter. Bounce pass comes in to Steiner. Steiner with two. Steiner with one. Floater in the paint, the buzzer. No good. At halftime, Rochester up 24-17. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Are you tired of your internet speed slowing you down? Not a problem. Get connected at the speed of light over RTC's advanced fiber optic network. Work, surf, or play on the net faster than ever before. Choose from multiple residential or business packages with speeds so fast, it'll have you flying away. Already have RTC's Fiber Connect internet? Upgrade your package today. RTC. Local services, local support, and local investments.
High score, a minute or so away from starting the third quarter. Rochester owns a 7-point lead here at recess. And there is a developing weather situation up here in Elkhart County. The athletic director told me before the first game, in case you're just joining us, that tomorrow night's game is in jeopardy. If they get what they're expecting to get, which is 4 to 6 inches of snow and 35 to 45 mile an hour wind, they've already made contact with the IHSAA at Shintown and basically told the IHSAA, with either team coming, either Rochester or Culver, they're both going to have to come from an hour away, and if it's blowing and near whiteout conditions, they're not even going to chance it. So they'll probably make that call early in the afternoon.
Yeah,
and if they do
so.
Cancel tomorrow night, it'll be moved to Monday.
Yeah, and you know we've got a ball game at Culver Academy tomorrow afternoon, the boys' game there, and the varsity tip-off is 2:30.
Yep.
We'll be on the air 2:20-ish, 2:30-ish.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, we'd like to say thank you to Jimtown. Their hospitality has been fantastic. The hospitality room. I'm telling you, you're lucky we came out of the hospitality room.
You're right.
Tonight was Italian night. Tonight was Italian
night.
Oh, my
gosh.
Thanks, Edie.
Oh, man. Yeah.
Some Italian
sausage. Yeah.
Some salad.
Oh, the table. You say there was salad. All I saw was the dessert table.
Well, I didn't see any green stuff. But tomorrow night, weather permitting, tomorrow night is going to be the All-American night.
Picnic night, yeah.
I may not come out of the hospitality room tonight. Culver starts the basketball. Over the top of the double team, and Snyder chucks it two rows into the seat, and Rochester are going to get it back. Again, they start the second half as they did the first half. Just took them a little longer to do it this time.
And again, it's a full court pressure by Culver.
Larkin will make that. Malcolm pushes, and her pass is kicked out of bounds. Bailey Abbott in the game for the first time since early in the first quarter.
We didn't see her very much in that first half of the ballgame.
Yeah, she had two fouls as well.
Oh, that's right. I forgot about that. Yeah, you're right.
Larkin,
so she's really the only one with Rochester in any kind of foul trouble.
Yeah, but she's fresh. I'll tell you, promise you that. Larkin high on the left side, make that Stasiak high on the left side, drives to the baseline.
Abbott working hard to get some position down low.
Kicks it out to Larkin through her legs, out of bounds. It'll go back to the Academy.
Wow. And, yeah, we talked about the Academy and their turnovers in the first half. They had 12 in the first half. Rochester had 13. So.
Yeah, not good.
Nope.
Steiner, high on the right side of Etheridge, makes the three, drives against Stasiak. Cut off on the baseline. I think everybody's waiting for a whistle. No whistle. Quickly to Blackburn. She pulls up from 15 feet. No good. Stasiak grips the board. Now pushes ahead to Holland. Rochester by 7 and runs. 7:15 to play in the third. Holland right wing.
Again, Rochester with just one field goal in the entire second quarter.
The Academy in a 2-3 zone, which surprises me a little bit, as many fouls as they've got individually.
Right. But it's been working for them here in this ballgame. They've created a lot of turnovers.
Stasiak loses the handle, and as she loses the handle, Culver comes on the weak side to help and kicks it out of bounds. So Rochester will keep possession baseline left. X studies over the top to Abbott, grabs it right in front of Coach Stasiak. Wrap around pass to Larkin and throws it out of bounds. play in the third. Rochester up by 7 at 24-17. That's exactly where we were at the break. Steiner dribbles to the top of the key. High on the left side to Blackburn. Blackburn one dribble to the near side. Well, that was Blackburn. Now left side to Etheridge. Long three for the Academy's off the mark. No good. Stasiak rips the board. Cowell is in the game for the first time for the Academy. Three for Larkin off the back of the rim. Nope. Stasiak grabs the board. She loses it. Ball loose. Holland picks it up. X wrapped around pass to Abbott. Layup on the way. Good. Bailey Abbott has her first two of the game in Rochester. Up by 9. Steiner at the free throw line. Floater on the way. No good. Stasiak, another rip.
She's got to be close to a double-double.
I'm going to have to send Randall a text.
Well, Bauch probably add him up.
Holland in the corner to Larkin. Allie, wraparound pass down low to Stasiak with the shot up. Good again. Team Stasiak is pushing the Lady Zebras back to an 11-point lead, and now we're going to have a foul down low on Malco.
Malco will pick up her first, unless she can argue her way out of it.
They changed one foul. I don't think they're going to change it.
No, I don't think they're going to change it.
So we got a sub coming in. Holzer will come in for Stiers. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman.
Val, you have.
Yeah, you're right, Brad. Val says Keaton has 10
rebounds, so yeah, along with her 13 points.
Cowell pushes off, and she is nailed for it. Turnover, personal foul on the Academy Lady Eagles.
That's her first. Team first of the half.
Coach Chris Lee will use another timeout. He is disgusted with the whole thing. It's a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Rochester by 11. Single-handedly thanks to Keaton Stasiak. That pass down low is taken away. Trying to get into a triple team. Bailey Abbott.
Trying to get it into Abbott regardless of what the defense is doing, and they pretty well had that shut off.
Cowell out to Steiner. Steiner around the defense. Pulls up from 15 feet right side. Short. Gets her own rebound at the elbow. Now backs it out behind the three-point line at the volleyball line and resets to the Academy.
2-3 zone by Rochester. As the Academy looking to work it down on the baseline, and Stasiak's going to pick up the blocking foul.
How many on Stasiak?
That's her second.
Stasiak just about got to the spot, but not quite, and she'll pick up the foul. As Rupp will come back into the game for Rochester with 5:09 to play in the third. Lady Zebras up 28-17. Becky Malco checks out. Holzer will look to get it in baseline right. Holzer. To Blackburn, fakes a three, drives it to the elbow, wraparound pass, tipped away, but Holzer there to pick it up. Out of Blackburn, over the top of the defense, Holzer out to Cowell. Quickly left side to Steiner, to Blackburn, behind the arc for the Academy Eagles, high on the right side to Cowell. To Holzer. Holzer travels.
Yep.
4:49 to play in the third, Rochester by 11, 28-17, and now Culver will be in a full court press as Stiers will come back into the game. For the Academy Eagles.
Stiers with two, Franks with two, Steiner with just one, Etheridge with two, Holzer with three.
They can now go back into the game, and Allie Larkin will have a seat. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Winner of this game will get South Bend St. Joe tomorrow night. They won earlier tonight by 21.
Frank number two in Class 3A, 22-1 record.
Larkin lobs it into Holland. Holland brings it up the floor, gets the man-to-man pressure. Holland across the timeline now against Steiner. Holland high on the right side, crossover dribble, middle of the floor, out to Ruff. Ruff makes it, drives it right, wrap around pass to Holland, three on the way, right wing, good! Holland with her first three-point bucket of the night. 31-17, Rochester up with 4:25 to play in the third. Blackford outside, Holzer, her three on the way, short. Long rebound to Stasiak, of course. Keaton has an opportunity to go. Wrap around down to Abbott. Abbott on the block, kicks it out to Malco. Becky around the defense to Ruff. Ruff makes the three. Malco, jumper from the elbow, short. Rebound fall four. And Steiner for the Academy comes out of there with it. Oh, ahead to Holzer, all by herself. And she loses the handle, picked up, kicks it out to Colwell. She traveled again, no call. She drives right, one dribble, outside to Blackburn from the free throw line. Jumper's good as it rolls in.
That's 31 first bucket for the Academy here in the third quarter.
Law pass comes into Malco. Malco around the defense. Rochester a 2-on-3 break. Abbott, jumper, good. Good look by Malco, good finish by Abbott. It's 33-19, 3.5 to play in the third. Blackburn at the elbow extended to her left. Outside to Holzer on the elbow. Now cross court to Blackburn. Blackburn against Stasiak. Backs her way in the paint. Fell off by the defense. Outside to Cowell. Top of the key to Holzer. Wide open three straight away. No good. Short. Abbott grabs the rebound. Bailey ahead to Holland. Rochester run. Heck. Oh. The Stasiak layup. Oh. No good. And knocked out of bounds by the Academy Eagles.
Boy. Stasiak split the defense, had a wide open layup, and hit the glass too hard.
I think that would probably draw another timeout from Coach Brisley. Kennedy Munson back into the game. Allie Larkin back into the game. Stasiak. And Dex comes out, 3:07 to play in the third.
Holland made a great decision there. She passed up the three. As the ball comes into Musselman, oh, she just misses the jumper and gets fouled. She'll go to the free throw line. Yeah, Holland high outside on the arc, passes up the open three, waits for her teammates.
She didn't want to.
No, but Stasiak right down the lane, gets the pass from Holland, splits the defense for the layup, but she couldn't get it to go.
So Kennedy's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. 6-foot freshman on the way is good. Nothing but the bottom of the net. She'll have one more. 34-19. Rochester up with 3 minutes to play in the third.
Holzer picked up her fourth foul.
Second one for the freshman is no good. And the rebound knocked away. Picked up by Holzer. Got a Blackburn. The Academy run. Blackburn outside right on the wing. Top of the key to Holzer. Left side to Blackburn. Now make that to Colwell. Nicole has the pass kicked away by Larkin. With 2:53 to play in the third, Rochester up 34-19. Coming back in for the Academy is Frank. And I missed the other one. I think it was Cortez.
Well, back in November, Rochester held Culver to just 13 second-half points. And tonight, they've only got two in this third quarter.
2:53 to play in the third. Dyers around the pick. Left side to Blackburn. Blackburn behind the three-point line, goes baseline to Cortez. Cortez with the basketball. Throws the ball away, but Cyrus picks it up high on the right side for the Academy Eagle. Cyrus drives the left, pulls it back outside behind the three-point line. Now to Blackburn. Down little Cyrus in the paint. Kicks it out to Cortez. Cortez, the left elbow. Backs away behind the three-point line to Blackburn. Drives it around Abbott. Hustling right there to cut off the pass. And nice shot by Kennedy coming on help on the weak side. Forces the pass to deflect off of Rochester out of bounds.
Abbott was able to recover. Kennedy, like you said, good job cutting off driving Holzer, and Abbott was able to recover and knock it out of bounds.
Blackburn over Musselman, no good. Larkin to the rebound. 34-19, Rochester up 2:15 to play in the third. Larkin high on the right side. Crossover dribble works to the left wing. Larkin looking for down low for Kennedy. Lobs it into her. Pass tipped away. And then there's a turnover. Culver has it. And Frank gives off to Blackburn. Blackburn down low to Cortez on the block. Get up. Cross court to Frank. She has a shot blocked by Larkin. And then the putback by Frank, I believe, is good. Or is that Blackburn?
I think it was Blackburn.
And it's 34-21. Another helter-skelter play for the Academy Lady Eagles.
Yeah, Blackburn's got both the field goals for the Academy here in the third quarter.
Larkin top of the key between the rings. High on the left side to Malco. Minute 35 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 34-21. Knocko drives it left in the paint, jump stop, down low to Abbott. Abbott loses the handle, but we're going to have a foul down low on Blackburn. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester with 90 seconds to play in the third quarter, up 34-21.
Blackburn picks up her second, team third.
Larkin will look to trigger it in baseline right underneath her own basket. Gets it in to Becky Malco for three. Yep. You can tell as soon as she let go of that, it was in. Steiner to Cortez. Jumper from the free throw line. No good. Long rebound to Becky Malco with a minute 10. Culver takes it away and falls out of bounds. So Rochester will get it back. 71 seconds to play in the third quarter. Rochester up by 16 at 37-21. Larkin, bounce pass into Malco. Becky pushes for the Lady Zebras. A minute to play. Loses the handle. Ball turns over again. Steiner then has her ball picked away, but Malco's going to pick up another foul. Frustration foul, I believe.
Right. And that'll be her second.
Brad right. Thomas on David Musselman. A minute 3 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 37-21 and back into the game for the Academy Eagles at Etheridge. Yep. Holland will come back in for Rochester. Nope, not until the next dead ball. Steiner gets it in to Frank. Frank left side to Etheridge. Under a minute to play. Pass down low. Swatted out of bounds by Rochester. Malco out of bounds. Holland comes back in and Becky will sit down. 57 seconds to play in the third. Rochester's up 37-21. King Stasiak had a huge night. She's had a lot of time here to rest in the third.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. Inbound pass comes in to Etheridge, and she is fouled before the shot because she was ran over by 44, for crying out loud.
That's just her second. Team fourth.
Cortez gets it into Etheridge. Frank backs away and throws up a tough shot. No good. Rebound to Musselman. She loses the handle. Ball still loose to the floor. There's going to be a scramble for it. Peck comes out of the with it to Ruff. Ruff middle of the floor. Rochester in a 3-on-2 break. Wrap around past the Musselman. Her 5-foot on the baseline. So good. Bailey Abbott has her shot blocked from behind. Picked up by Sires. Sires then is going to be carried. Called for a carry. It'll go back to Rochester. 37 seconds to play in third.
Well, Rochester more than likely will look for the last shot of the quarter. As Larkin will look to get it in and does so to Holland.
35. Next across the timeline with 32. High on the right side with 31. Law pass down little Musselman. Kennedy jumper off the window. Good! And now we're going to have a step over the line violation on the Academy Eagles. So, Brad, you're still going to be right. And now the Academy,
or another,
the Academy will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Jimtown High School, 24 seconds of play in the third quarter. Rochester up 39-21. And after the Academy turnover, it'll be Rochester basketball to bounce baseline right. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Keaton Stasiak, fantastic game. And Val from the Rochester Sentinel Sports Editor was just talking about Morgan Ruff's defense, and it's been locked down.
Yeah, she's been face guarding Steiner all night. Steiner had 15 against us in the November ball game, and she's only got the 1 3-pointer tonight.
And now we're going to have a foul away from the basketball before it even comes in on the Academy. And I saw a one. Number
one. Sires. Yes. That's her third.
24 seconds still. Larkin looks to get it in over the top of the defense. Larkin on the wing. Dribbles to the wing. Dribbles inside. Doesn't pass down to Musselman. Kennedy's jumper off the glass. Good again.
Musselman now with 9.
41-21. Rochester by 20 with 10. Sires with 8, backs it out behind the 3-point line with 6. Jump pass is deflected, and it's going to go out of bounds. And they go to the last touch by the Academy.
Chris Gottlieb, I think.
Rochester going to get it back with 2.8 to play in the third, leading by 20. Holland, baseball pass into Kennedy. Kennedy, down low to Abbott at the buzzer. No!
Oh!
After 3, Rochester up by 20. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Here we go to the fourth and final quarter. Well, am I safe to say, Rochester up by 20, am I safe to say here, Brad, it's been a story of the post-play tonight for the Lady Zebras.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. It's Musselman off the bench. She's got 9. Abbott got into early foul trouble, but then she's come back in here in this third quarter and created opportunities for not only herself but for her teammates. Stasiak, a double-double. She's got 13 points and probably just as many rebounds. So, yeah, I would say definitely Rochester's found themselves some post opportunities tonight.
So Rochester will start the fourth and final quarter of the basketball, leading by 20 at 41-21. On the floor for the Lady Zebras, Musselman, Abbott, Ruff, Larkin, who's trying to get it in, finally does to Abbott. And Bailey dribbles away from trouble, gives them a Ruff. And Holland, the other, is the fifth of the Lady Zebra on the floor.
So Culver with just 4 points in that third quarter, and Rochester able to build the 20-point lead.
Holland looks to get it down to Kennedy, can't get it to her. Now to Ruff, high on the left, right side, now to Larkin, middle of the floor. Larkin drives it right. Kim Petras jumps off at the elbow. Outside to Ruff. Ruff in Steiner to Holland, high on the right side. Holland looking down to Musselman, can't get it to her. Picks up her dribble. Top to Larkin. 40 seconds gone in the final quarter. Lob pass to Musselman. Kennedy has her 11 points. And then she gets knocked down. She gets knocked to the floor hard. They stop the play. She gets up. A little over-dramatic for my liking. But if she needed a break, all she had to say was she needed a break.
Yeah. Aren't you supposed to pull on the front of your jersey when you're ready to come out?
Yeah. I mean, I've never seen a flop like that. 43-21, Rochester on top.
Just trying to savor the moment. Give her dad a minute to catch his breath.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Yeah. She might get a raise in her allowance. Hold her for 3. Nope. Offensive rebound. Cortez put back. Yep.
Well, that's Cortez's first basket of the evening.
6:50 to play in the game. Rochester up by 20. Holland, top of the key to Larkin. Back to Holland, high on the left side. Next against the man-to-man defense. Wrap around to Bailey Abbott. Abbott out to Holland. 3, left wing, on the way. Good, as it rattles in.
Holland with her second 3 of the ball game and her 11th point.
3 now in double digits.
Yep.
46-23. Cortez. And then Kennedy's going to pick up the reach-in foul. It'll be her third. I'm okay with that foul.
Yep.
So Stasiak and Holland make that Malco back into the game. Larkin and Ruff to come out. 6:28 to play in the fourth quarter. Rochester up by 23. Holzer. Bounce pass into Cortez. Jump over the defense. Too hard. Rebound to Musselman. Gives to Stasiak. Keaton runs for Rochester. And Coach Stasiak says, hey, let's slow up a little bit and run some clock.
Spread the floor. Take our time, look for some good openings, see if we can't create an easy bucket.
Stasiak on the wing, outside to Larkin, and she is fouled. I beg your pardon, to Abbott. She is fouled, and from here on out, Rochester will shoot free throws. I believe that's her 6th. Yep, maybe not.
That's Holzer. That's her 5th, team 5th of this half.
Team 5th. 6:08 to play. Blackford back in for the Academy Eagles. Rochester up 46-23. In the winner of this game will get the Academy tomorrow night in the championship game, weather permitting. Malco gets the basketball in from Holland. Works to the wing, now top of the key. Works against the man-to-man defense. Drives it left, out to Stasiak. Looks down low to Abbott, can't get her. To Holland at the right elbow. Peck steps back behind the three-point line. Now dribbles to the left wing. Drives it right. Shot on the way, we're going to have a foul. It's going to be on the defense, and that's going to send Holland to the line to shoot two.
To see who they called the foul on.
I think it's Cortez, I believe. Nope. Yep.
Number 3, it is Cortez. No, I'm sorry, number 4.
No, you were right.
Nope, number 3.
3, okay. Yep, Cortez.
Cortez, that's her 4th.
Holland's free throw is short. Larkin will come back into the game for Rochester. 5:50 to play in the game. Rochester up by 23, and Kennedy comes out of the game. As Larkin comes back in. Next is one more for the Lady Zebras.
Rochester with the win tonight, which I think we're safe in saying they're probably going to hang on for this win. We'll get their 20th win of the season. First time they've had 20 wins in a season since they went to state back in 2004.
And then Rochester steals the basketball and then throws it away. And, of course, the last touch by Frank on the far sideline. It'll stay right in front of the Rochester bench, going to our left, leading by 23 with 5:40 to play in the basketball game. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Day, don't forget tomorrow, the Rochester guys back in action. They are on the road at the Culver Academy Eagles.
Yep, and that'll be a 1 o'clock JV start.
Yep, and, of course, the draw is on Sunday as well.
So. Well, you definitely want to tune in tomorrow because, if a weather situation does occur, we'll have that on the air for you tomorrow afternoon, let you know what's going on tomorrow night.
Holland loses the basketball, then it's kicked down the court. Morgan's got to pick it up and just does before it goes out of bounds.
I think she had to think about that for a minute.
Yeah.
Who touched it last?
Well, she had a long way to think about it. She had a long way to get that. And they're going to have a dump pass down low to Bailey Abbott before the pass. They're going to have a foul on the Academy. And Larkin will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus with 5:10 to play in the game. Rochester up 46-23.
So Frank picks up her third foul, team seven.
As we're promoing things, don't forget the WROI telephone auction starts tomorrow, 9 o'clock. I know you haven't bought anything for Valentine's Day yet.
When is that?
It's coming up pretty quick.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Fairly soon, I believe.
I don't have any idea.
Shocker. Free throws, no good. Falco with a rebound. The Stasiak. Deaton then has it ripped away by Sires. Sires in the paint, has it ripped away again. Rochester turns Culver over again. Then Holland bounces it off her foot, and they turn it over again. Now Blackburn has it around Holland, high on the left side. Wrap around pass down low. Is taken away, ball loose again, is still loose, and going to the corner is McGinnis. And now we're going to have a tie-up between McGinnis and Holland. McGinnis is thrown to the floor, she's still down. Holland walks away from the action. McGinnis slow to get up. And I believe she's crying down there on the baseline.
Yeah, she's not going to get up.
We're going to take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Rochester up by 23 and now playing keep away with the Culver Lady Culver Academy Lady Eagles. Well, listen up, because this is might be the first time in a long time, or maybe you never hear it again. I'm pretty proud of what Kennedy has done tonight.
Right.
This is her second game in a row, varsity uniform, that she's got a double went for double digits, and it was a big deal tonight as Culver strips the pass away. Stires goes up for the layup. She's fouled on the hip. Malco
pick up her third. Yeah, again, 11 points tonight. Go along with, I think, 10 points she had last night. So, another good effort from the freshman off the bench.
So, Stires at the line to shoot two freebies. Kennedy and Moe will come back into the game for Rochester. First one's up for Stires, and it's good.
That's her 10th point of the ballgame. Her first point since halftime.
Larkin and Abbott comes out. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 3:56 to play in the game. Rochester by 22 at 46-24. One more for Stires for the Lady Eagles. Eyes it, flies it, good. Nothing but the bottom of the net.
Yep, she either needs to get a double-digit jersey or cut her hair.
Because you can't see,
can't see the numbers.
And then Holland is fouled at the timeline, so she'll go to the line to shoot one in the bonus with under 4 to play in the game. So again, like Brad was saying, they're kind of finish up that thought of what's coming up tomorrow. The guys will tip at 1 o'clock, JV game at the Academy. We'll have that broadcast for you tomorrow, weather permitting. That's about around a 2:15-ish, I'd say, pregame start as a tip for the varsity somewhere around 2:30. Holland hits the free throw. She'll have one more. And, you know, you'll be sure to want to check in just to make sure that the game tomorrow night for the Lady Zebras at St. Joe is still on.
Yeah.
As we monitor the weather.
Yeah, St. Joe in the championship game, they cruise there, winning one on Tuesday and one on tonight. They cruised in there.
I suppose you could probably say Rochester cruised as well. They're going to win by 20 tonight.
This is a much, much, much better game played tonight than it was even winning it by 19 on Tuesday night. Grace Piper in the game for the first time for Rochester. X comes out. I'm guessing she's done.
Yeah.
Steiner over the top of the defense to Blackburn. Blackburn spins away from trouble in the paint. Jumper all the way over the defense is good. Alexi Elliott will come in with the next dead ball. Piper picks up her dribble over the top to Ruff. Ruff, middle of the floor for Rochester. Crosses through the center circle. Works it down low. Kicks it out to Piper. Grace at the volleyball line, high on the right side. Around the defense. Bounce pass to Malco with 3:15 to play. Rochester up by 21. Stasiak now has it middle of the floor between the rings. Keaton drives it right. Wrap around past the muscle, and Kennedy off the window. No good. Gets the roll. Rebound to put back on the way. No good. And she'll go to the line to shoot two. Just finish
it. She's trying to get some rebounds filled up.
Yeah, Pad her stat. That's all you had to tell me.
Yeah.
Kennedy has two. First one, too hard. So I have one more. Lexi Elliott comes in the game for the first time. Another freshman for the Lady Zebras, and Becky Malco is done. 21-point lead for Rochester. The Muscleman at the line for one more, looking to push her numbers to 12 tonight. Kennedy second on the way. Good this time.
Northfield defeated Southwood 50-30.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. It's going to be a Northfield Wabash championship game tomorrow night.
Right.
Sires, the Steiner. Three, short, rebound tipped around. Culver loses it out of bounds. It'll go back to Rochester. And now Hannah Odell will come back into the game, and she'll replace Keaton Stasiak. Keaton's had a fantastic night. 2:54 to play in the game. Rochester at 49-27, over in a full-court press. Piper over the top of the defense to Ruff. Moe runs around the defense. Moe on the baseline. Brings it back out against the double team. Picks up her dribble. Outside to Piper at the timeline. Grace around the defense. And she almost travels. Gets it to Lexi Elliott. Off her foot. Picked up by the Academy. Down low to Steiner. She loses the handle. Out of bounds. Going to go back to Rochester.
Trading turnovers now. Both teams had over 30 turnovers in the first game. They both got over 20 in the second game.
Now we're going to have a foul as both Stiers and Lexi Elliott were running for the basketball, and I believe Stiers is going to pick up that foul. That's going to send Lexi to the line to shoot two. For the Lady Zebras, a 2.5 to play in the game.
Stiers fourth.
Lexi at the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras. Four freshmen and a sophomore on the floor right now for the Lady Zebras. Lexi's first one is no good off the side of the rim, so I have one more. And coming back into the game is Cowell. And Etheridge will sit down. 2:36 to play in the game. Rochester up by 22 at 49-27. Elliott with one more for the Lady Zebras. Freshman, eyes the second one, lets it fly, and this one's good. 50-27, Rochester. 2:35 to play in the game. Blackburn runs the point for the Lady Eagles. Blackburn through the center circle, works high on the right side to Stiers. Stiers over the top of the defense. To Cowell. Cowell to Blackburn, drives the baseline. Down low, jumper on the way, no good, muscle under the board. Kennedy over the top of the defense to Piper, now to Moe. That shot was by Kabuka. Ruff loses the handle, ball loose, Lexi Elliott picks it up. Ball still loose, we're going to have a tie up, and it's going to.
I don't know.
It's not lit up on the scores table. And now Rochester will get it back. 2:05 to play in the game. Rochester up 50-27.
Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Elliott looks to get it in on the sideline. Lexi studies, gets it in to Pfeiffer, and it's actually knocked out of bounds by the Academy Lady Eagles. And Coach Stasiak says, hey, Mo was right there.
Yeah, just standing
into her.
6 feet away from her and wide open.
Yeah. So Rochester will try it again with 204. Elliott looking. And now Rochester uses the 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Rochester up 50-27. Rochester looking to move on to a sectional championship game for the second year in a row against the South Bend Lady Indians for the second year.
Fifth year in a row for the sectional final for the Rochester Lady Zebras.
And second year in a row against
St. Joe.
Yeah. So Elliott gets it in the rough. Mo drives it right at the right elbow. Bounce pass to Pfeiffer. Loses the handle. Gets it back. Gets it to Elliott on the right wing. Bounce pass down to Mo. Under two to play in the game. 50-27 Rochester. Rough around the defense. Outside to Pfeiffer. Grace on the wing. Picks up her dribble. Now to Rough right in front of Coach Stasiak. Mo against Cowell. Around the defense. At the elbow. Picks up her dribble. And we're going to download it. Hannah Odell. Wrap around. Pass to Musselman. Layup was good. Great look by Hannah Odell. And that post-to-post passing. I love it.
Yep. That's 14 now for the freshman.
1:25 to play in the game. Stiers against Pfeiffer in the paint. Outside to Steiner over Ruff. Three is short. Rebound. Tipped around. Ball loose. Culver comes out of there with it. Stiers jumper. No good. Ball is still loose in the floor. Musselman hits the deck. Loses out of bounds. And it'll stay with the Academy underneath their own basket. And they're going to send Frank back into the game for Culver. With a minute 11 to play in the basketball game. 52-27. Culver up. Garrison will come in for the first time. Alexa Garrison, Stiers.
And Dahlquist.
Yep, and Dahlquist.
Well.
Cowell. Baseline to Blackburn. Outside to Stiers. Stiers on the right wing with a minute three. To Blackburn. Three is blocked. Bumps with the rebound. And then Kennedy gives to Elliott and then travels. So, Dahlquist comes in. Kennedy comes out. Morgan Ruff comes out. Alexa Garrison in. With 58 seconds to play in the game, it's Culver basketball baseline right. Cowell looks to get it in. Bounce pass to a wide open Frank. Her layup is good. 50 seconds. 52-29. Rochester's going to get South Bend St. Joe tomorrow night in the championship game. Pfeiffer against the full court press. Bounce pass to Elliott. Lexi crossed the sideline. It's going to be fouled by the Academy. And that's going to send Lexi to the line to shoot two free throws for Rochester, who lead 52-29.
St. Joe won their two games this week by a combined, 65, 70 points?
I'm telling you, they are
very, very good.
Elliott has one free throw tonight. Lexi's first one off the side of the rim. No good. She'll have one more. 44 seconds to play in the game. Rochester, as Val just pointed out for us, and for the fifth year in a row, looking for a sectional championship. Second one, no good. Rebound tipped around. Culver then is going to tip it out of bounds. It'll stick. Ow! That's a bad call. It's going to go back to Culver.
Well, when you've got the juniors on our team leaders,
yep.
They've always gone to the sectional final. That's what that tells me.
Yeah, good call.
It's a freshman starting their freshman year.
Really starting their 8th grade year, so it sounds like.
Well, right? Except they weren't playing varsity their 8th grade year, yeah. But they started as freshmen.
35 seconds. Rochester up 52-29. Long jumper for the Academy, no good. Ball tipped around. Frank comes out of it with it. And then Frank is fouled down low by a Garrison, I believe. And that should send Frank to the free throw line for one in the bonus. 26 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 52-29. Get on the bus, get home, get rested, Yeah. Frank has one of the bonus. Takes a long time in the line. Shoots it. No good. And an offensive rebound. Blackburn goes to the basket. Throws up a shot. It's good. 20 seconds.
Blackburn now with 10 points for the Academy. Off the bench.
52-31. Elliott across the timeline with 12. Elliott picks away through the defense with 10. Loses the handle. Blackburn picks it up with 7. Blackburn against Piper with 5. Layup is good. With 2, with 3, now do it. Rochester going to move on to the sectional championship game by defeating the Lady Eagles of Culver Academy by 19, 52-33. Post-game show next, 93.1 WR.